Hi everybody. Am I audible to all of you? Am I audible to all of you? Can you look at my screen? Hi. So, yeah, so only 30 of us. So let us wait a little bit for all of us. Very good afternoon, good evening to all of you. Thank you. So how was the trading week? Overall, how was the trading week overall? It was not volatile. It was straight one way up. Last trading week was not at all volatile. It was not volatile. I will show you the daily chart. Where was the volatility? There was no volatility actually. If you talk about the index. It started from here and then it marched like this, going up and up and up. And Bank Nifty was even more robust. So I think it was not that volatile. Last 2-3 weeks have to be volatile because it was before budget, because there was fear in the market that there will be COVID cases and other kind of cases that will come in, but that didn't come in. I am not a financial expert or economic expert, I would say, but overall, because having a background of finance, MBA, overall it ticked quite a few of the boxes, like a bank. There was no new taxes. The government was spending enough. There was the thing about bank privatization of the government privatization. So I think it was a very very good budget and one of the better budgets I have seen in last 8-10 years, like including Pranab Mukherjee ji, Chidambaram, P. Chidambaram, Arun Jaitley ji, and now Nirmala Sitharaman. So these four people in last 10 years, whatever budget I have seen, I thought that this was one of the better budgets. And if you see, out of the last 10-11 years, this time the budget was so good that the market went up 5% on the very day. So I will discuss about everything. Let us wait till 6:10 for some of the other people to come. So overall, you should have made enough money because on the Tuesday session, when Bank Nifty was around, I think, where was it, 34,200. I told you that the Bank Nifty would be going to hit 36,000 in 2 weeks. It did in 2-3 days. So if you had gone long in Bank Nifty, you should have made huge money, isn't it? So I think you should have made good money in the Bank Nifty. It was said that it was cleanly going up to 36,000 and it went up. Today there was a bit of profit booking, but yeah, that may change on Monday, we will see. So let us wait for 4-5 minutes till 6:10, I would say, and we will discuss. See, Ramesh Sharma ji, the question you have asked, the should we enter as soon as the breakout happens? This is a very subjective question based on the kind of market, kind of stock. It is very, very subjective question. In many cases, yes. In present kind of market, yes. Because often the breakout is true. In normal market, which we have not found in last, I would say 11 months from the Feb end to 12 months. 12 months have been not been the normal market. So apart from in the last 12 months, entering in breakout and breakdowns have worked well. But in normal market scenario, this doesn't happen like this. So it will be different. So if you take it as a rule, then it is wrong. But yeah, in a present kind of market scenario, often entering just at the moment of breakout is more useful. Vineet Mahajan ji, please, if you have attended any of the previous sessions, you know that I cover all the major stocks in Nifty. Please don't wait. No, Asian Paints, I won't. Asian Paints, this is one of the stocks that I have noted down for discussion. I will discuss, but please don't put here the question, request on individual stocks. You can put in TMP or the club. There, the individual stocks will be discussed. But here, no one, please, it is request to everybody, this session is not for covering individual stocks, okay? Not answering the queries. I will be discussing stocks which I have already found out to be good for the next week. That let us discuss that. Apart from that, any queries you put into the club, we are working on Saturdays also and Sundays also, there are replies. You put it into the TMP, we will answer. Okay. So disciplined people are not paying price for the latecomer, because why I am doing is this, because there is again a lot of questions they ask that sir, please discuss this sector. It becomes a difficult thing. I will definitely let you go before 7. Don't worry, sir. Rohit Khanna, sir. Rohit Krishna, sir. Didn't understand bad banks. I also don't know. I don't know fundamentals, sir. Sir, we also discussing commodities in today's session. Yeah, a couple of commodities I will discuss. Don't worry, sir. Sir, I know I was only trying to... Array, don't worry, sir. I am just saying that we are not discussing stocks. Any stocks, sir? You are in TMP. You can any moment ask any questions in the TMP. Don't worry. Okay, so let us begin. It is almost 6:10. Yeah. So see, before going to the budget and everything, I will like to draw your attention to something very important, which may sound uncorrelated, but it is very relevant in today's context. Now look at this. I'm enlarging the screen a little bit. Now the daily number of cases has been coming down. I told you the daily number of cases would go up during the peak of the winter, which is December and December. But from January, the number of cases has been coming down. And as you can see, because the death number, the overall death number actually starts coming down after the cases coming down. Okay, so first cases come down, but death number peaks a little bit later. Similar thing is happening. Now, what is expected? It is expected that as it is coming down, and as we move through the month of February, like probably we won't reach this 15,000 in most of the days. Going forward, let us see how many deaths were there yesterday. 5 lakh cases and 14,000 deaths. So 15,000 is not going to be crossed. And the moment we reach March, we will be in this zone, like every day maybe maximum 5,000 deaths. And as the vaccination goes on, eventually, maybe by June and July, this daily death rate would come down below 1,000. India is planning to vaccinate all its population within this year only. And by the end of July, they are planning at least the vulnerable section by the end of June. So we can understand that possibly, and this will happen in European countries also, and as the summer arrives, the fatality rate, the everything will come down. So what happens after this? You might have seen that right now the death casualty is huge in the case of USA. Every day 3,000 to 4,000 people are dying, and Europe almost 5 to 6,000 people are dying. Okay, now these are the main economic centers in the world, the Europe and the USA. Now what happens as they become a little bit they recover from this, the overall economy will pick up and the overall transportation will pick up. Now, all of us, or if not all, most of us are doing right now working from the work from home mode. Okay. Now, this will change. Let me show you this. Before going to equity part, I want to show this part. And you remember, right, on that day when we were discussing, just a second. I told you that 60 is very near, and it was that day it was here. I told you that 56 first it is coming, and then 56 above 60. And my personal view is that Biden has a little bit inclination to favor the Arab nations or Middle East nations. So he may actually push the oil price, try to push the oil prices in the 70s. So if Brent goes 70s, this will go to 65. Anyways, so we are almost looking for again 20% rise from here in the in terms of oil prices, because what is going to happen is that the oil demand will rise, but the Middle East countries won't increase the production very fast, so the oil prices will rise. So for some time, at least from the month of March and April, we will see the inflation pick up. Now, any idea? I'm talking a little bit about the macro terms, because to me this looks headed for a zone of 65, 66 anyways. So if that happens, you understand that there would be inflation, okay? And there would be inflationary pressure, if not anywhere else, at least in India. Because what is happening is that presently there is $6 trillion of worth of liquidity that was printed last year. And what happened across the globe last year? Last year, Indian economy, like this financial year, is about to contract around 7 to 8%. US around 3 to 4%. Many major European countries 10 to 12%. Now, India is projected to grow 11% this year. So what happened is that the pie was 100 in Europe, it has become 90, suppose, or 92. Now, Europe won't be growing that fast. Europe would be growing 3-4% a year only, and US is likely to go 4-5%. It is India that is going to go 11%. But what will happen due to this is that even after 2 years, suppose there was no COVID, what would have happened is that 100 would become 107, and then next year it would have become 113 or 14. Now what happened? 100 went to 92. Even in case of India, it becomes only 103. So instead of 114, India is 103. To make up for this loss growth, what will happen is that all the economies will run very high liquidity, and in spite of the inflation pressure, they will have low interest rates. Now, you have to understand that this is a very very peculiar phenomena. When interest rates is low, I'm talking a little bit about macro because this is important. You have to understand. Okay. Now, little bit about macro, that what if the interest rates are low but the inflation is high? So what is happening? The borrowers, like the consumers, the businesses, they are borrowing at a lower cost. Their cost of capital is low, and due to high inflation, they are able to pass on the inflation to the customers. So what will happen? They will have exaggerated profit margin. You are understanding? The profit margin would expand in most of the industries, because due to the gap that is being created, like that 900 that has become 92 may become take 2 years for Europe to become 100. So 3 years have gone and they are at the same point. If there was no COVID, they might have been 105. So maybe 4 or 5 years down the line, they will be approaching. And to do that, they have to compulsorily do a do a very important thing, that is keep the interest rate low in spite of high inflation. And that's why most of the businesses will find it very, very, very easy to increase profit margin. And that's why you may see abnormal profit margin growth compared to 2019 also. Like 2020 was bad. I'm not talking about that even. And what happens when the euphoria reaches, people will think that people may think that or that this is going to last forever, but this won't last forever. Things would definitely worsen at a point of time when Reserve Bank will be forced to, and all the global market, global central banks will be forced to tighten the interest rate. But that is far away. Now, I hope the points I made was more or less, if not fully, understandable to you. Right? RBI, SBI result. Sir, SBI, sir, see, I'm not an expert in RBI policy, sir, but overall it was accommodative. It was accommodative for time to come. That's they said. Okay. So basically, you have to understand there is huge liquidity, $6 trillion that is flowing around. And that is in spite of this kind of higher valuation, abnormal valuation, due to this pandemic. And last time when this pandemic happened in 1920s, there was not this kind of a monetary policy. But this kind of inflationary monetary policy, what is happening is that we are crossing the, what I would say, the depression spiral in a year, and we are moving into growth. What happened in 1920s is that after that Great Depression, there was a decade of depression and slow growth and contraction took place. That is called Great Depression. Okay. But after that pandemic, the Spanish flu, but because the medical sciences are also evolved, we are finding solution within a year. And also you can see with much less death, because at that time the global population was 180 crore, and out of that 5 crore people died. Sorry, 9 crore people died. 9 crore people died in Spanish flu. And now global population is more than 700 crore, only 20 lakh. Every life is important. But if you talk about the scale of this time, the world has lost 0.3% of its population at that point of time, or it may maximum lose 0.4 for now. And that time it had lost 5% of capital. Okay, 5% of human race. So due to this monetary policy, the bubble that is probably going to get created is enormous. I know that what I discussed may not have been completely been understood to you. And it is not possible also, if you don't have a background in economics, to make you understand everything what I'm trying to say. But overall, you have an idea that these are extraordinary time, and probably next 2 3 years would be very extraordinary in terms of growth and everything. Okay. And let us look at the market from that point of view. I won't be discussing that what the market did. I won't be discussing the what market would be looking next year, next week. Okay, because we are here to trade next week. Past is past. If we earned last week, very good. If we didn't earn last week, then that is our own mistake, nobody else's fault. Now see what is happening here. Very, very simple. Nifty is trying to go up after this sharp dip. And just look at the things that had happened earlier. Like there was a kind of a dip. This was a 950 to 540, 400 point dip. This time it was almost 1000 point dip. Now after that it was 13, 1400 point rally in the Nifty. Okay. Let us look at the Bank Nifty. I'm not saying that certainly this will happen, but trust me, when such things happen, like such breakouts happen, they generally don't happen for a very small amount of time. And forget this count is over now. Okay. This count is over now. 35,500 has been achieved. This is over now. We have to revisit the market. So I'm deleting all this stuff. Okay. And I'm deleting all this stuff. Now, what is possible is that to me, 40, to be honest, let me draw a Fibonacci line here in the Bank Nifty. See, we are right now in a very abnormal kind of market that won't last forever. But the factor is that till the time it lasts, we need to respect it, and it is likely to last for next couple of years at least, I think. Like, see what will happen now. Those who are in the market right now are very lucky people. Trust me, they are the luckiest people. Like, what will happen is that Nifty, probably that will happen is that Nifty, Bank Nifty will reach such a kind of a level in next 4 or 5 years possibly. And if yeah, it will be a little bit shaky during the next election if there is the scope of a very unstable government. But otherwise, across globe, what is likely to happen is that there is likely to be a mother of bull market. And like I'm telling you, Nifty in 2008 was 6,000 at the top. Then it went down, and in next 2008 to 2020, it has only moved to 12,000. So in 12 years, it has only doubled. Try to understand that. Peak to peak, if you are talking about. Now, what will happen is that if we talk about 2004 to 2008, when the global bubble was created before the subprime crash, Nifty went from a level of 2000 to 6000. Nifty multiplied 3 times. So probably it can happen that over a period of, who knows, over a period of next 2 3 years, we may be in a position which in normal circumstances is not possible, but due to this pandemic related thing, it may be possible that we may reach 20, 25 or 30K in the Nifty. So which is Nifty becoming 2.5 to 3 times in a period of, because it was 10,000, 12,000 few time back in a span of 4 or 5 years. And then who are into the market, they had made a lot of money during this point of time. And then it may happen for next 12, 14, 15 years that 30,000 may become only 50,000. Okay, so you can understand what I'm trying to make is that the time that you are right now into the market is, you are very lucky you are into the market, and this is a once in a generation. Like 2004 to 2008, it was there. Due to the pandemic, it has come, otherwise it would not come because the economy has matured. So you have to understand, at this high inflation and low interest scenario, this is a very extraordinary scenario. And next generations of people who will be into the market will scream about that we are unlucky, and really they will be unlucky possibly. Anyway, so what I'm trying to say is, see, it looks very feasible to me that for now, let me put something at two also. Yeah, 42,000 to 48,000 over a period of maybe 1 year or 2 years, it is very possible. 1 2 years it could be much higher, but 1 year it could be possible. That means that it will happen. No, we are not sure, but we will try to play with stops, we will try to play with the logics, and we will try to play. We won't be trading for 40,000 with a stop of 30,000, right? We are not doing that. So we will take day trade, but what I'm trying to right now is give you an idea that what is likely to happen. So for now, 42,000 and 48,000 are open in the terms of Bank Nifty. Let us look at the similar levels in the terms of Nifty also. I wanted more and more people to attend today's session, because today's session is something which is very different from the things we discussed. And similarly, as I told, the Nifty can Nifty and Bank Nifty both look in the weekly chart. The way it looks is that they are possibly going to move quite a bit of higher. Like, I'm very very optimistic, I would say. I won't say confident that Nifty is going for the 17, 18, 19,000 level maybe in few months. That I am having. And if you remember that when 12,000 broke this level, 12,400, I directly gave you a target of 14,200 and 14,800. At least people in the TMP knows. Others at that point, this session was not going on, so you might have not got my view. But I was through my Twitter handle and everything, I was very confident that at least 15,000 or 14,800 is going to come. Now, given this candle, this particular candle, and if Nifty stays above 15,000, the higher levels are also very much into the card. There are few points people are trying to make. Yeah, it can be. It has scope to be a mother of bull market. I'm not sure that because based on the macro things, I have a perception that this can happen. I'm telling you. So let us look at Nifty. I have looked at. Let us look at the indices. See, Nifty auto looks don't. See, on the average, everything looks bullish, but Nifty auto had a very bullish week. Every indices would have had a bullish week. So indices, I will go to the daily chart for now. But before that, let me go to the main stocks of Nifty and Bank Nifty right now, and I need to discuss few stocks of my choice also. Okay. So right now, Nikunj ji did last week, and all of you are ready with pen and paper that whatever stocks we discuss, you will be ready with the levels at your end, that on Monday you have everything on your mind. Okay. So let me go back to the daily chart, and do you need 1 minute to get ready with the pen and paper? Do you need to get 1 minute? Okay, I will give you 1 minute. Just arrange your pen and paper and sit down. We will start in a minute so that all are ready with the levels of the next. Yeah, I'm giving it for everyone. I know not everyone is ready. Giving it for all the people. So at 6:32 we will start, and just giving 1 minute and few seconds, get ready. Sir, ETF, you please ask into the fundamental club, they will explain. I am not a fundamental analyst, sir. Ramesh Sharma ji. A little bit of water. So what you do is that after noting down what we discussed, you please put the levels and everything into respective group. Like, you can put into the club, you can put into the TMP, and that will be helpful because only 70 people are here. There are 2,000 people, so others can have access to the things that has been discussed. Many people may be right now in office not able to attend it. So let us do help everybody. So 6:32 is here. I'm starting. So the first of the stocks is Bade Bhai. Who is Bade Bhai? Who is our Bade Bhai of all stocks? Mota Bhai in Gujarati call, which is called Bade Bhai. So Bade Bhai is still in a weak mode until and unless it crosses 1950 it is bearish and possibly it can come down. It can come down, but if it starts sustaining above 1950, it can go towards 2080. But possibly it can come down at least towards 1894, and if that is broken, probably 1860. So right now it is bearish. Reliance is the biggest of 10% weightage. Then SGFC. Again, not looking very bullish. Last 3 4 days, dojis are being formed, and I won't recommend that someone should buy and hold until and unless 2800 is crossed on the upside. Someone rather, if they are willing to take some risks, can try to take some short position with a stop around 2780 or 2800. You have to understand something, that what I am telling you is told till now is about the few weeks that we will be discussing, that few months that are going to come. Okay, few months or few weeks. And from now, what we are discussing from Reliance is what we need to do next week. So next week it can happen that after a 1500 point rally, Nifty can correct 300 points. That's not a big deal. Understood, everybody? So right now what we are discussing is the level. What is the important level for next week? And what we discussed till now, till before that, is the what is the overall next 6 months, 3 months, few years outlook. Okay, so SGFC is looking, not looking bullish, but if it turns about 2800, go on the long side. Okay, this is SGFC and Reliance. Next, ITC. On a breakout mode, I don't know. I think there was no excise and all these things. And given everything is rallying, there is a possibility. Let me squeeze it. There is a possibility that it will go to 241. But let us not discuss this stock. Just let us keep in mind that the 240 is the kind of resistance, and it can get resistance here. ITC I generally avoid. Okay. Okay. Now, then comes Larsen and Toubro. I'm talking about the non, and you can see that 1600 is the kind of resistance, and right now there are a lot of inside bars, so no clear direction, because, and it is very difficult to trade also. So because this inside bar is 130 point long, 160, above 160 it is definitely bullish, but till then it can come to 1472 and then again bounce. Not a very clear view. So HDFC, Reliance ho gaya, Hindustan Unilever. See, Hindustan Unilever I posted everywhere actually. So see, I am not going into Elliott wave count. What happened is that there was a rally, and then the rally was 5 wave, and ABC, that is the corrective wave, gets completed. Now the likelihood is that this is 61.8% level. Likelihood is that if this level, that is 2200, is protected, and if eventually it goes about 2290, possibly this is heading for a very very big move. Like this move was how much? 2100 to 2400. So it was 2000 to 2450. So it was around 20% move. So possibly we are again beginning a 20 to 30% move from here with a very small stop loss. So those who are looking for some positional thing, this is right now also, this is in a very good sweet spot. It has rallied only 2-3%. In the morning also I showed this also, and I tweeted about this also. In the Stockage Club, in the Telegram group, we tweeted about, I posted this, and in the thing also. So So this is the thing I have posted, and I think it can move a very significant rally from here. This is my thing. So Hindustan Unilever is there. Next week's stock, let us discuss a little bit about ACC. All the cement stocks have been bullish, but it is not bullish. But still, you can buy as long as 1710, 1715 is protected. Possibly, it will go towards 1800. Okay. So now let us move to banks. So I will talk about big banks right now. So let me before that let me look at the Bank Nifty. The Bank Nifty daily chart, it show that it has a possible shooting star, and that is the case. It may come to 35,000, but I don't think it can it can last below 35,000 in hourly chart. At least we will try to buy on dips as long as it is above 35,000. In the hourly chart, I will show you. See, this 20 hour SMA comes at 35,215. Monday, this will reach around 30,400, 500. So that can be the possible bottom. It may not come towards 35,000, and it may go up. Okay, in spite of today's candle. Today was a RBI day. Not necessarily it is going to go down. Okay. Now let me talk about one stock in this is and I don't think that very quickly it is going to break this 36,640 also. It may try to consolidate a bit. We don't know the way it has moved. SBI. I will start with an SBI. See, if I'm talking about this, let me show this to you. Monthly chart. See, from 2008-09, you had to understand. This was the gap up at 390, and then it went up and it pulled back to 390. Try to understand, had it been any other stock, I would have loved to say that this is going to rally maybe 200 points more. Even this can do, but being a PSU, I don't have any conviction, because what I have seen is that over the years, public sector organizations, though they are good for the country, but they have not generated wealth for the investor. So I'm telling you that I am not very confident about this, but this stock has shown this kind of a breakout, lifetime breakout. Okay. So now those who want to play with a small quantity can play for a move towards 500, 550. But given a choice, for my money, I won't be doing this, because this is a PSU. Because historically, very few cases very rarely have made money for people. Okay. Now, HDFC Bank. Coming back to daily chart. Potential to rally more above today's high. So keep and watch on this. If it stays above 1625, I would say, if we mark it also for my students, it can rally more above 1625. ICICI. Until this high is crossed, 640, don't go long into it. It can correct to 595, that is this 5 day low EMA. Axis Bank. It has created a bearish engulfing candle. Okay, so below this 712 level, it can come to 703. Not worthy. Try to note that if it is breaking our 780, its all-time high is 840 around, it may be heading towards that over the next few months. So what is this level? 768. Okay. So the market Bank Nifty failed due to correction in this. Kotak. Very bullish move. Possibly heading towards 2047 or even higher. This has completed a very good correction. Looks good to me. Okay. So Kotak is on the bullish side. And above 202, it may go to 2050. Which one we have missed? Axis, ICICI, we have discussed. IndusInd. Looks to me that 1080 is the hurdle. Not necessarily it will be bogged down by the hurdle, but it can. Okay. So this is about banking. One sector that looks good is that Nifty Metal. Yesterday went up, today also pulled back once towards the mid Bollinger, possibly heading towards this. So if oil prices goes up, all commodity prices goes up, so it may do that. Let us look at each stock. Tata Steel looks very bullish above this high 690, probably again going towards 730 and above. JSW Steel, if it pulls back to again this level 392, try to buy it. Looks decent to me with a small stop loss. If it pulls back, try to buy it. Jindal, sorry, little bit of acidity. Yeah, looks bullish. Possibly will break this high also, 310, but look bullish. Even 310 is 5%, it can rally that much. Hindalco. Hindalco doesn't look very bullish at this moment. A little bit tepid. Let us not discuss this stock because it is not clear right now. Okay. Finally, VDL. Can buy with a small stop loss of 170. Try to buy it. It can go towards 190 given the firmness in all the sectors. Okay, a few stocks are looking good. Suddenly the Adani boys have started going up. Now if there is a pullback towards 557, then that would be the golden opportunity. Even if there is a break above 615, you can go. Adani Ports had a little bit of bearish candle, but no matter that, if it goes above 675, you can 678, you can buy this. This looks very bullish. Okay, Adani Boys, Adani Green. No view as of now. Still, let me put an alert above. Last is Adani Transmission. Obviously above 550 you can go long, but for now possibly it would consolidate. Right, so these are the Adani groups gone. Nifty Realty. Okay, I want to show you one chart, is that is GLS. Okay, I noticed it today, and the factor is that I have been bullish in DLF for quite some time. Today one of our participants in TNT, Raiz ji, actually asked me on DLF, and to explain it I discovered this. See, above 250, it has been a multi-year breakout. and possibly it is heading toward 468. Above 315 high it would go, and it looks a kind of a bullish. Once so another is the Prestige. Now I have to go back to the daily chart. So for a longer term, SGA, Hindustan Unilever and DLF, we could discuss. Now this is the daily chart. See if sustains above 316.17, it would be good. Next, Prestige Estate. Not nothing. Godrej. Nothing very big deal. Still, let me put all alert after 1435. But not looking great. I'm just putting for my knowledge that where it is going. Okay, don't note it down. Oberoi Realty. Not looking very bullish. One stock that is looking bullish is Kajaria Ceramics. Okay. Now it can correct if it breaks. It has been such a phenomenal stock since September. It has become three times. I don't know how long it will go, but it can go like above 915 more. It can go. Okay. SRF. Few stock randomly I am seeing. Okay. So 56, 5780. I am writing. Please don't write down it. Let us leave it. If this talk, it is only for my understanding. So Nifty Auto. Nothing bad. Overall bullish. Today's candle was bearish. So if the high is broken, 11,020. It goes up 11:20. You can see the thing. Okay. Now let us look at stock. Tata Motor had a correction. So it may dip to this level, 305, 306. If you get around this with a small stop loss, try to go long. As I told you that I think the stock is going to be reaching 370, 380, and I have been telling this thing from the level of 170, 180. To people to buy, and on the way it has doubled. 370, 380 is around the corner. Okay, I missed to watch two stocks. Bajaj Finance. Yeah, this guy's looks bullish. So 5670, above 5670. I have a watch on this and Bajaj Finserv. Okay. Yeah, about 10,000, 10,020, 10,050. It can be bullish. Both are looking bullish to me. Possibly this small range will break, and it will break on the upside. So Bajaj and Bajaj Finserv and Bajaj Finance both look good. Let us look at Shriram Transport in this context. Shriram Transport, okay, can correct, but if goes above 1500, can be bullish. Overall looking bullish. All these housing finance, okay. Last one stock, Chola Finance. Nothing big deal. Still, let me mark it. Okay, so back to auto stock, Bajaj Auto. Kind of consolidation in last 2 days. No view at the moment. TVS was going high, today, now see, if TVS trades below 620, it can come to 604, but again, not great opportunity. Mota moti bearish, nothing to say. Just a second. Hello? কোথায় দাঁড়িয়ে আছে? ফ্ল্যাটের গেটের বাইরে? হ্যাঁ, তো ফ্ল্যাটের আপনি আপনি বেল দিয়ে আমি খুলছি। সো আই হ্যাভ আ পার্সেল, কুড ইউ জাস্ট ওয়েট ফর 1 মিনিট, লেট মি কাম ব্যাক। Let me come back within 2 minutes. Yeah, sure. Thank you. I have got an Amazon parcel and I have to make the online payment and ticket. Just spare me 2 minutes. Thank you. Yeah, so Maruti we have seen. Now we will be seeing the TVS motor that we have seen already, right? Hero MotoCorp. Not very convincing. Tata, sorry, Mahindra. Above 900 credit from the bullish side. This is Mahindra and Mahindra. Last is Eicher Motors. Above 360 credit in the bullish way. So write down Eicher Motor and Mahindra. Okay. IT is looking bearish. Nifty IT I will show you. Looking bearish, IT is looking bearish. All IT stocks are more or less looking bearish. And right now, I would like to discuss few stocks which I find lucrative in the shorter side. Okay, one is Asian Paints. Asian Paints Limited. See, as the crude oil prices goes up, possibly this is a raw material impact that we will find. That there is a problem when the crude oil prices goes up, and you may find that below this 2365 you may like to short this because it has already broken the golden ratio in 2400 and possibly it is going down lower. So three major stocks that one is DLF which is a longer term bullish. Hindustan Unilever, which is a longer term bullish, and this can be a longer term bearish stock. Okay, so we'll keep an eye on this. Okay, the pharma is looking good. Sun Pharma, if it grows above 650, you have to look at it. Lupin, not very bullish, but if it stays above 1060, you can buy it. It can go to 1120, but not a very high momentum move. Cipla, nothing special. Now, finally, Apollo Hospital. Apollo Hospital. About 2800 only bullish. Can correct to a lower level of 26. 10, 20, try to buy it at that level if you get it near 2600, 26, 10, 20. Okay. Berger Paints. One of the stocks which has broken down structure. See if 690 is broken, trade it on the downside. Okay. So similar to the Asian Paint, they will show you the kind of movement. Now, I don't discuss this stock, but the factor is that there is a potential kind of because the crude prices are going on. So how much the government can actually pass on? So those dilemma would come. So below 100, try to take a short side view in this stock. You may be lucky on the downside. Okay. In a high crude oil scenario, actually Reliance does well, but I am not sure why the Reliance stock is not doing. Nifty Realty we have already covered. So what is left is Nifty FMCG. That also the main stocks we have discussed. Nifty IT is covered. Nifty Metal is covered. Okay, so we have covered all that thing that we plan to cover. Regarding gold and silver, I would like to show you. See, this is the gold. Gold is near very important bottom of this 1780. If this does not hold, gold can go towards these levels. See, what happens in this kind of a market is that all this gold and silver will not sustain higher levels. They will be this kind of sideways. Win from a level of maybe 20, 25,000 Nifty or 30,000 Nifty to start coming furiously, then you will see that flight to safety in gold, and gold may be reaching something around $3,000 or $4,000. So one should actually do a little bit of SIP in gold also as part of asset allocation for a shorter term point of view. As long as below 1870, it right now, if it breaks this level of 1770, it can go to 70, 38, 40 also. Silver. See, silver is looking bullish as long as it is above 26, and possibly we will soon see a move towards 27, 28. And I'm very confident on it. I'm quite confident on it. Crude oil, I already told you. So all the commodities also covered. So 3-4 minutes extra, I'm sorry that I had to take, but that is only because this parcel came. Otherwise, I would have left you within 7. Yeah, the important thing, dollar index. Just a second, dollar index, we need to discuss. Last but not the least. Very, very important. 92.58 is the thing, but I have given you a write-up on dollar index and FII holding. See, this is a kind of a all the kind of a trend lines that you could have drawn. This has been breached. And I told you that this was a very important support level in a monthly chart. Just a second. So this was a monthly chart. From there it is. Now we don't know. I don't think that dollar would be allowed to run up this much that all the global markets fail. Maximum 92.80, 92.90, and that's where 5 month high EMA also comes in. 5 month high EMA is also there, and I think from there it will trade below 90. And once it breaks below 87, 88, gold and all the crude may skyrocket. Yeah. So this about it. Media is Z, and that was the result reaction. Media sector is only Z. Okay, Sun TV, because the Tamil Nadu elections are coming. I have told about this stock for very long time to all of you. Sun TV Network. Sun TV Network. I told you that the day it will trade above this level of 530, 540, possibly due to this. Because see, right now there is no JLLB. You have to understand. Earlier there was AIDMK, DMK. Right now there is no JLLB. So what can happen is that if they once win the power, they can be in the power for quite a bit of time. And though I shouldn't make ideally correlation with the political outcome and stock, but to be frank, about 570, 580, I'm very, very bullish on this stock. I have told you about this stock from this 510, 12 levels, and I'm really fascinated about this stock because my office in Malaysia was just beside the kind of office that Sun had built around 10, 11 years ago, Sun head office. This was an amazing office, like very, very few news channel or news media houses could think that kind of office 10 years, 11 years back. So right now, if it is able to expand freely, I am really fascinated. I will be really fascinated about this talk about this 550, 560 level. So, and I should not make a political outcome forecast that DFK is going to win. Anyone may win, but yeah, common sense a little bit. That's it. Okay, Bharti is a sector in itself. Let's mobilize here. not sustaining of 625. No view. Let me look at the daily chart once again and find no view. Okay. Not no view. This is a very good support area, 577. With a 570 stop loss, you can try buying for a target of 625. So write it down as one of the most important stop for this week. Thanks. I was ignoring it, but it turned out to be one of the best picks. Right, I will tweet about it also. Bharti looks fine. Thanks. So that's all. No, sir, individual stock I'm not going to discuss. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Hope you have a great next week. Bye-bye. Please write a summary of the things that I have discussed, and I will share it with everybody. Bye-bye. Take care. Thank you.